bunch of interviews set up today. Let's hope that they pull through. Waved her like I knew her too. The girl on the left, I'm sorry. Where Robert used to sit. Going to start warming up a lot. It's going to be almost 60 degrees here in a day or two. I was wondering if they would come back up here. Thank you. Get some interviews done today, definitely. I just want to get this little drive through. I want to see if I find it and locate anyone. Because it is warming up. You can see it's everything's starting to, well, not everything, but snow is starting to melt a little bit, which I think it said 61 on Thursday, maybe? Makes it really challenging for these people because, you know, it's hard to keep stuff, so. You know, when you want to take off your really cold. See Amber after I do all. I got a bunch of stuff today. I gotta go to South Philly, interviews, Amber. I gotta go to Center City too. Oh shit, I'm sorry. Go ahead, I didn't see you there. that Frank back there that I never figure out what he drives. I think it's that Barber thing back there. I don't know. I was like zoned out. Go get these interviews over with right now. I'm going to be interviewing this girl that I didn't even realize it was her, honestly, and I probably wouldn't agree to do the interview, but this girl used to date a friend of mine. I met her when I first got clean. Her boyfriend at the time, her boyfriend at the time's son, I went to rehab with, and then we were, we've been close ever since. He just texted me out of the blue 20 minutes ago, but I met her through them, and she's been struggling the whole time in and out of rehabs, and so I kind of like kept my distance with people like that because they keep getting high. There's no reason for me to talk to them, when I'm doing good. All right, just had a real productive day. I think I got 5 interviews done. I could have had more. Caution. I always feel bad for this guy. He's so mentally ill. He just screams at himself, and he looks aggressive when he's asking people for money, but he's not aggressive at all. Well, anyways, I got like 5 interviews done. Keela. I had brought some bedding down for Keela. And she asked me if I wanted people to do interviews with. And I said, yeah, set it up for today. She's like, I got a bunch of people that want to do them. And I said, I want to do my channel, which I'm not trying to toot my own horn, but when I hear the actual people that live down here, you know, stay down here, that they want to do specifically my channel because they like it, that means the world to me. It could fall through a lot of times, though. You know how it is. It even started to this morning. I came down, saw him, or I came down, called her, nothing. That's why I left and went down to South Philly. Oh, crap. Oh, man. I forgot. Damn it. I still gotta go to Center City. I forgot to do that. So hyped, I was on my way home. Oh well. I've been doing the interviews, I've been talking about food. I just had this awesome cheesesteak. My fat ass can't stop talking about food when it's good, so. Then I gotta go see Amber too, and it's gonna be a busy long day. I didn't even think. I got done the last interview. I'm like, all right, sweet, time to go home. Enjoy. Be relaxed and be a bum. But it's only like, I forgot, like half my day isn't done yet. At least it's warm. Had an awesome conversation. Shamid, a black gentleman in a wheelchair, missing his leg from Trank. Such a cool guy. It's one of those people you meet and you start talking to, and like it feels like you've known him for years. Just drew. I'm just an idiot. I literally drove right by on the way back here from South Philly. I drove right by where I gotta go. Yeah. So I guess I'm gonna stop this drive-thru now that I just started it. To run to my brother's. I always wonder, and I try and think how, you know, the people that are down here, what they feel about the YouTube channels. And I know a lot of them don't like it, and a lot of them do like it, whatever. It felt good today to hear, like, they had, I think, three of them. The one older guy, Black, he was, like, in his 50s. He like almost started crying when after the interview was over, when he was thanking me for doing this. It was really sad, really, you know, it was sad to see or hear, but it was also made me feel good. But he was just like, thank you so much for doing this. You don't, people need to see what's going on with us. And then I had another, the other guy I was just talking about, the Shamad, I forget, man. I gotta remember his name better. Even he said it. He was, you know, thanking me for doing this. And the thing that makes me feel really good is when I ask if I can do follow-ups with them and stay in contact with them and, you know, stuff like that. And when every one of them, like, oh my God, yes, please, please, you know, stuff like that. Like, I love this. I want to keep doing this. And that feels cool. Damn, I just ran that fucking stop sign with a cop right behind me. Oh well. I don't think I stopped back there, did I? Maybe I did. Oh well. Alright, I'm gonna pause this.